Returns to Oakland.
Hey, yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is.
A legend with an almost decade-long absence from the scene will challenge the undisputed face of modern battle rap. It's two legends, two conflicting viewpoints, two opposing ideologies. The most anticipated battle of the year. Disaster versus Soul Kahn.
We out here day two. You know what I mean? MOB. We got the line, people trying to get in. Dig.
Oakland fostered some of battle rap's greatest artists. One performance here can solidify yourself as a legend. And in 2010, that's exactly what Soul Kahn did.
When Soul Kahn battled QP, nobody had seen him shit like that. Yo!
It was one of those like straight like movie type situations.
One of the biggest body bags in battle rap. Period.
You make tracks about how you flossing and you clap rounds, yet that ain't exactly what I found in this here background check. That's true. This file says your lifestyle ain't fit for a baller. Your average income's $28,453, but street money's off the books. That's how you're paid, right? And you in a game, so you probably seen some court dates, right? Wrong. I checked that shit too, from federal or state, and you never been charged with one felony. But wait, there's one unspeakable act that this wicked man committed. In 2004, he had a warrant for dodging a traffic ticket.
He was like, I'm gonna pull out a file. Like, nobody ever did no shit like that.
Who the fuck am I? All that type of shit. All the sons were standing there, and then Soul Kahn's is up there, and he's ripping into QP.
I put my life into my lyrics. You rap to pretend. I terminate careers. You never had one to end. And here's the last thing I have to say to your crew. Fuck you. Fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you.
That by far was the biggest reaction in MOB.
That was our first ovation.
Soul Kahn was an unstoppable force, and his contemporaries commended him for it.
Most of the battles that have replay factor for me are bodies. The Soul Kahn battle where he has on the white suit. Who's he battling? Yeah.
He was the first person where you were like, whoa, this dude can get on stage and clown you the entire time, looking like a fool himself.
I love Soul Kahn. He knows how to rap. His approach is he's corny. I'ma be the corny dude that's gonna clown on you. You the cool nigga, I'm corny and I'ma clown you. He's hard to defeat.
So are you good at rebuttaling?
The one battle where I just choked in the round.
Motherfucker, fuck.
I then turn the whole tide against it by having the illest rebuttal I've ever had in my life.
Your obsession with short black men's a scary omen, guy. Hey, where were you the night that Gary Coleman died?
Nice choke, by the way.
Yo! Motherfucker, I could beat you if I did or didn't choke. Where was I on the night Gary Coleman died, giving your mom a different stroke?
The whole building exploded.
That is
so good,
fucking
man.
Awesome.
So good.
That's made every, you know, great rebuttal compilation that's ever been made.
Soul Kahn had what it took to progress in battle rap because you couldn't rattle him, you couldn't thug him, none of that stuff didn't matter. He was able to get around all of that, and then he just like disappeared into the abyss.
What up, YouTube? It's your man, Soul Kahn.
Why don't I battle anymore? Y'all wondering? Let me answer. No battle rapper who has a successful musical career on the level that I want to achieve is an active battle rapper. That's not me hating, that's scientific fact. So, music, music, music. I ain't gonna be in the ring anymore. Sorry about that, but I got music to make up for it.
I've been wishing I could Tylenol the pain. Lie to you and follow through after Obama fought for change. Yeah, I got soul, that's why I got it in my name. I can stand on hot coals, y'all just walk a flock of flame. I ain't really built for your sensitive ears. I really ended careers, so with the message ain't clear. I am ever good, so get used to me. Or the next record you hear will be a eulogy.
Hold on.
SoulCon, I think he made a mistake by leaving battle rap. What are people gonna say? Bring up his songs in a battle? Like, what is it really gonna do besides put your shit more in rotation and gain you even more fans that right now don't listen to your music?
I say shut up, y'all say fuck up, shut up, shut up.
In the span of 2 years, I think I did well over 20-something battles. And if you put that all together in this amount of time, it's really like a few albums. Music's always been more important to me. And I've sort of entered battling as a fluke in the first place. So it meant a lot to me, and I'm grateful for what it did. But, you know, you can't be a battle rapper forever. I'd rather be regarded as an okay known musician than the world's greatest battle rapper.
I fucking hate being introduced as a
disaster.
Battle rapper.
I'm actually prideful about being a battle rapper.
And you say battle rapper for sure.
I think it's an incredible thing.
It's different than you being like, I'm a rapper. Yeah. And people are like, you're a rapper. You
everybody fucking rap.
I'm telling you, the battling shit will get the average person that is not in tune with shit to respect more. Because what we do requires skill.
While SoulCon prioritized his musical endeavors, Disaster carried the torch of battle rap to new frontiers.
I'll stop you out and make you a part of this history.
Oh.
Don't show me that, because this is about to be the body bag of the century. Hold on, hold on. You motherfuckers ain't shit to me. They say karma's a bitch. For you, it's probably dentistry, because the part of your mouth that's missing is only a reflection of what's scarring you mentally. So the gap between your teeth exists merely as an object of imagery to distract you from the real gap between us, and that's bars and delivery.
The gap in your teeth is just an object of imagery to distract them between the real gap between us, and that's bars
and
delivery.
And that's a testament to why this is like the one of the best in the world.
I know you motherfuckers watching me. Nah, you ain't stopping me. Shut the fuck up, bitch. You owe me an apology. Just because I'm acting like a dickhead, you ain't gonna cut me off. I ain't gonna let you Lorena bobbing me. Bitch! 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 Chill!
Like his adversary, Disaster was known for destroying his opponents.
Hey, yo, check it. Look.
When the rules are fine, I choose the spine.
And he said, when the rules are fine, I choose the spine. And from that moment, I was like, this fool died.
I hate it when they call me Disaster. It makes me want to lose my mind. I'm not Joe Knight or Disaster. I'm the two combined. I'm an upgrade and I'm a new design. I take some of your rhymes and take some of mine. I do it like your eyebrows used to be and fuse the lines.
Fucking one of the best impersonations I've ever seen in my life.
Disaster's unrivaled passion and hard work turned battling into a career.
Disaster is one of the biggest names in battle rap, period. He has the most views. He's brought the biggest names and attention to King of the Dot out of any battle rapper in the world.
You can't have a talk, Grizzly Mains, with this.
Disaster, the fucking face of modern day battle rap.
I love y'all, man.
Disaster put on for the West Coast since a kid, and now he became who he became. He done made it to the movies, he done battled cannabis, all these other niggas. He was the first nigga doing what niggas is doing now, battling the industry niggas.
Cassidy.
He did it all first.
When I took it as a passion and career and decided I'm gonna do this for the rest of my life, there was no such thing as it. There was no such thing as you're gonna be able to make money one day and actually pay rent and have a normal life because of your rapping skills and killing people. You don't make records. What?
Disaster parlayed his ambitions into multiple creative ventures.
I'm in the refrigerator!
From cartoons to music videos to starring in Hollywood feature films.
battle rappers think that music is the next step, the industry. Mm. The industry is a backwards step. The next level after battle rap is acting.
I'm here at the 2017 Midnight Madness program at the Toronto International Film Festival, and we're here for the world premiere of Bodied.
We just had a movie that won all the awards at the places, and you gotta understand this is in Hollywood where you can't say crazy shit. We're saying like fucked up shit in this.
Woke cocksucker.
Hey, you know, you got SJWs and all types of people tripping out about it, and we still won awards with the critics. Mm-hmm. They were like, nah, we understand. Like, we get it.
It's definitely gonna cross some boundaries and it's gonna get offensive, but we gotta have thick skin, baby. Oh, we gotta have thick skin out here, man.
Man, give me that shit. Man, I'll stomp these into pieces and fragments, and now you can keep them. He can have this. Now you get to complete your dream of being this genius math whiz, because everything you see is in fractions. I get the fuck out of here, you little fucking dweeby faggot!
Motherfucker, you know the style,
as time progressed, Sol Khan continued to distance himself from battle rap.
There's so many things that I used to say in those battles I can't be proud of. I can't really look at with any respect. And people fight me on that.
Yep,
but
particular moments, because I was going to ask.
Anytime I use homophobic language, wasn't cool.
The comments actually made me really rethink how I approached language. I rethought that a lot because of how people talked about it online. I'm now a lot more true to my values in everything I do. There are words that I said then I would not say anymore. I use the other F word a lot in battle rap. And
F-A-G.
I use it all day, all the time. I even used it like, not like homophobically in my mind. Mm-hmm. I just used it, you know, like in the sort of Louis C.K. sense of it, you know, mm-hmm. just saying like, but you can't, it keeps that word alive. I don't even say the B word anymore.
But bitch?
I don't say that.
Why?
Because it's sexist. At the end of the day, it's misogynistic. It's underlined. If women want to say it, fine, but like, I don't say it.
So kind of word.
He's a changed man. Look at the range, man.
He got a whole new game plan.
Sol Khan was outspoken about his political beliefs, and it clashed with some in the battle world.
Maybe people give words a little too much power. The bigger of an issue you make it, and the more power you fuel to the fire and give all these words, and they mean so fucking much. Imagine if nobody gave a shit.
Or if we just didn't.
Imagine if nobody gave a fuck.
What I'm saying, the words that you don't want to have impact besides the entertainment of battling, it's still gonna upset people.
Yeah. We live in the world where people like to get offended for you.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
They're offended. I'm like, yeah. Bro, I'm the one getting Asian shitted on, and you're offended for me.
I see that with him shit all the time.
I hate that shit when people try to get offended for you.
Do I get offended?
Yeah.
I don't, but that's because I don't give a fuck about any of these fuckers. I'm sorry. I'm heartless. I'm soulless. So that's why I don't. I don't have an emotional attachment to anything they say. I don't believe anything they say.
I know a lot of people say, oh, you soft because you're all politically correct. It's like, no. The soft thing is to just go with the trend, which is to always be an asshole. The courageous thing and the actual, like, transgressive, different shit to do is not be an asshole to everybody, because there's some real bad shit in the world, and we don't fight it by letting, like, entertainment be this refuge for being a dickhead to everybody. Like, that doesn't matter. It doesn't help anyone.
There's consequences in battle rap, bro. That's not what people should worry about. If people are worried about racial shit and shit like that, that's the funny shit.
Right.
People really come there and be like, your friend that died, your mom like this, you know what I'm saying?
It's like you want to keep reminding the audience that this is a battle. They don't actually mean what they're saying. The fact that I can appreciate it is proof that this is just talk.
And I think the more you show that in a battle, people understand what this thing is really about. It's about sportsmanship, respect for the MC. It really is building character with each other, and it's something brutal for online. You can't like walk up to like Denzel Washington and just be like, yo man, you gunning too much people down in your movies, bro. You're a fucked up person. Like, I seen what you did in Training Day.
Yeah.
That's what we're doing. Like, we're putting on a form of content for you.
King of the Dot shocked the world when they announced their marquee matchup for Town Business 2.
Sol Khan returns. I never thought I'd say those words.
After being gone for fucking 9 years.
Sol Khan versus Diz?
He's coming back to battle Disaster.
That's nuts.
SoulCon has returned. He's going against Disaster. King of the Dot really just made this happen. I don't know what they told him. I don't know if they got the Godfather, Al Pacino, Michael Corleone, and said that offer you can't refuse.
Right. I don't think it was money.
I don't think so either.
I think it just might be passion.
It's the itch.
It's the itch.
I think maybe he's bored. I don't know why. We gotta find out what's going on. Maybe like he's not loopy in what he's doing, or I don't know. Like, why'd he come back?
You know,
you know who he got coming out.
Can't release it?
Oh,
you don't know. Say, yeah, it's been announced. It's been announced.
Oh, the battle.
Disaster. Yeah,
the battle. Oh, yeah. I think
he's battling Disaster next month.
Yeah, he's battling Disaster. Oakland, right?
That's gonna be huge.
How did this battle get set up? Did he call you?
It popped up on my feed. This battle viewing.
Yeah, I would love to get SoulCon.
Yeah, but I always found it so funny. You know, everybody thinks he's gonna come back. I'm like, dude, he is not gonna come back.
You know, but it's crazy because like I understand the reasons he's not, but it's like also this is a platform to kind of use that message to convey it.
That's a hell of a good point, man.
Like, you can come back and make a big difference in battle rap by pushing your stance and your view and using this platform to convey that message.
And it came back up in my feed and I was like, okay, you know what? Maybe he's right. I'm at this point where like there are things that I've wanted to say in this format specifically that I should have said here instead of just everywhere else but here. Right. And Gannick was always talking about, it as a platform, about battle rap as a platform that he thought that I was kind of missing out on. And I was like, you know, he's right.
He left in this world where he had said faggot a bunch of times and then he felt like way different about it later. And I thought it would be better for him to be able to get an opportunity to go in the ring and right those wrongs as opposed to just be like,
so yeah, he probably got in that ace up the sleeve, maybe.
Yeah,
then,
some angle that
maybe.
And there's a reason why he came back for it.
Exactly.
Well, he had this whole thing where he's saying he's seen on Watch Organic. I guess he got inspired from that, but it's probably like part of it. I'm not denying that. Maybe that got him thinking. But you know, I dissed him like 3 weeks before the offer came to me. When I say back in the day, me versus him would have been better, but now he'd get ripped apart. 3 weeks later, I get a call from King of the Dot saying SoulCon want to battle me. So he probably wrote his ass off and then felt like he was ready. And had to hit me up about it.
I asked for this. I did. Right. Just so people, folks know, like it wasn't pitched to me. I was like, I should battle Disaster.
I think it's great that he's battling someone like Disaster because he has an opportunity to be like, you epitomize all the shit about this that I wasn't down for. You know what I mean?
He's a very, very, very ruthless fucking kid. That whole smiley.
Yeah, I don't fall for that. Yeah.
That whole pussy attitude that he pushes forward. You know what? He's a wolf in sheep clothing. That's so cool. He appears like a little fucking sheep, and he's going to attempt to go for the jugular because that's what that kid does.
It's just bars, right? Like, what in his scenario, when it benefits him, of course it is.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, it's just. But like when he wants to bring up the topic to somebody else, it's not just bars, people will be hurt. Someone in some state next to some other state, next to some other state that I don't know will be hurt. They will be hurt.
Shut up.
This weekend, the time has come.
Make some noise, y'all.
The gloves are off.
You know you back in battle rap, right?
I'm gonna show folks there are a lot of ways to degrade a person.
King of the Dot!
Diz lives and breathes battle rap.
You know what we're doing, Disaster Man. I love doing this shit. Fuck you!
A most anticipated battle of the year.
This is the dream matchup.
Disaster versus SoulCon.